Welcome! In this video, we will see some tips on how to optimize 3D models for supportless and faster prints, mainly to save resin and time when we need to do a batch production. So, in this example, there is this two parts case. Before completing the model, I want to find the best parts orientation to maximize both print speed and batch quantity. For speed up the print time, I'll print at 150 microns layer, that is a good resolution for functional prints. We are used to tilt the parts at 45 degrees and fill them with supports. But in this way, I will print only one case in about 2 hours, despite being printed at 150 microns. And use 106 grams of resin. The case is only about 40 grams, so with tilted orientation and supports, I would literally waste 60 grams of resin for every case. If, for example, I want to produce 100 cases, that would mean to waste a total of 6 kilos resin. So, I decided to optimize the model for print in this vertical orientation, because in this way I can arrange 14 cases in one single batch and print all of them in about 2 hours, unlike the tilted orientation. On the right there is the non-optimized version with the embossed text and the lens cavities all with flat overhangs. So I modified them with some bevels that act like supports. The text is only 0.5 mm thick, and in some cases little overhangs like these can be printed even decently without these optimizations. But since there are too many variables involved, resin type, printer model, etc., you need to do some tests before print the final parts. As you can see, it comes out quite good, only up to 1 mm, while it starts to show layer separation from 2 mm and above. On the back cover there is this engraved zone for an hypothetical label, and the upper part is a long overhang, so I simply beveled it. Now let's see the inside of the case. Remember that this is the growth direction of the layers. The non-optimized version is now on the left. Here there are these reinforcements, but with this orientation they are all overhangs. Same thing with the cylindrical connectors. So I rotated the reinforcements by 45 degree angle. Then I beveled the LEDs reinforcements. I also added this little prism for support the cylindrical connectors and change these pins to a conical shape. I also added all these prisms in the upper part every 5 mm, and a big one all along the flat part of the shell. Here you can see the difference between the two versions. While this is a macro for compare the 150 microns layers versus the 50. On the other side, as already done previously, I added these little prisms to all the cylindrical connectors. The top ones are only for reinforce the cylinder. These macros show how bad is the non-optimized and unsupported version. With the last optimization, I added some cross supports to tie together the two sides of the case. In this way, they can support each other against the peeling forces. Once finished, it's better to do a check before print to verify if there are any unsupported areas, that are technically called islands. For the print, we used a new resin we found on Amazon, It's called Conjure Rigid, and it's sold by Chito Systems, the same company that developed Chitubox and the motherboards of almost all resin printers. I must say that this resin surprised me. In our lab we are constantly searching for the best mechanical resin because we print many functional parts, and this resin has maybe the best quality-strength-price ratio. Also the definition is very good. Moreover, I like both the deepness of this black and the slight blue tint, compared to other resins that tend to yellow tint. Well, we hope that you find this video useful. If you have any suggestions or questions, feel free to ask in the comments. Thanks for watching.